you would go back and you would go on duty and you would look at the ops board and you'd see that there were ops on tonight, and you would know that some of those people were not going to come back.
Pilot Peter Swan.
When we took off, the whole side of the aerodrome was absolutely covered with people cheering as we went down.
Flying in darkness gave the bombers some protection against fighters, but less against flak. Hamden pilot Robert Key.
The flak was always unpleasant, always gave on a nasty turn. Next thing I remembered was a shattering of everything. Total feeling of chaos. But I remember very strongly feeling that the engine had no power.
The fire started around about the middle of the aeroplane.
Rear gunner Harry Jones.
There was all sorts of smoke and confusion, and by this time we'd lost a lot of height. And there were flames all around, and I thought, well, the best thing I can do is get to the front through the hatch and get out. But by that time the aeroplane was pretty badly smashed up. There were bits hanging off. I was hit in the back first and come across, and then through the ankle, and I rang up the skipper in the front and said, look, I've been hit. And it bloody well hurts. There's no doubt that Fred was dead. He'd been hit with a lot of bullets. I saw his body shuddering, and his colour went from green to grey. Oh yes, he was dead.
I remember finding we were a spin. I remember thinking, this is it.
For every airman lost, there were family and friends left behind.
Well, the inevitable happened. That night he didn't come back. I remember standing on the watch on this roof, staring out into the sky and thinking, you've got to come back. The aircraft has got to be there. It's got to come back. And I dissolved into floods of tears and ran off. I'd never lost anybody before. I didn't know what it was like. And it really was like having something torn out of me, I felt at the time.
Nearly every close friend I made in the war was written off. It seemed like a jinx, because you don't make more than four or five. But as each one would go, and then I'd make great friends with one or two others. The ones who I would laugh and always talk to in the mess or sit joking with the crew. They all went. But when they go at the time, there's this awful feeling of regret. But it's momentary, and you put it out of your mind. But it's since the war, and particularly now as I get much older, that I think of them much more. And it's now that the sadness comes over me. And the faces of my closest friends float across my mind.